What's up everyone, it's your boy Sun Wukong, and the time has finally come. Rewrite episode 1. You don't know how excited I am to finally immerse myself in this greatness. This playthrough has been a long time coming, and I'm so fucking excited right now, you don't even understand. But before we dive into it, there are a couple logistics for the playthrough that I want to run through, and, you know, if you're not interested in hearing about that, which I don't understand why you wouldn't be, I will let you know when I actually start, so you can just skip ahead and get to that. But give me a moment for a second. Listen to this greatness. Listen to this OST. Let me just bask in it for a second. So sexy, man. Absolute godly OST. I can't wait to hear all these tracks in their full splendor. But the time has come, as I've said, and we're gonna dive straight into it. The first thing I want to say is this first episode, I really want to kind of feel things out and test some things with this first episode. So the length of this is not going to be as long as, you know, the following episodes after that. I'm guessing this is going to be anywhere between 30 and 40 minutes for this first episode, and then my plan for, you know, the episodes going forward is to have it be, you know, anywhere between an hour to an hour and 30 per episode. So that's the length of the episode. I'm still not 100% sure on the upload schedule, but there will most likely at the very least be 2 episodes of the playthrough a week, if not 3. I'm still not sure on the schedule, like I said. But before we dive in, there's 2 things I need to say right now, man. And just think about this for a second, okay? I cannot play this game without this godly OST, and that's my biggest apprehension going into it, to be honest. And effectively, that's why I think this is most likely going to be on the second channel that I'm creating. Hopefully you guys give this your full support regardless, but I just don't want to risk anything on the main channel. So we're gonna test it out like this. If everything works out okay, I might consider bringing this onto the main channel instead, but I just want to play it safe for the time being, especially as far as the music is concerned. I'm not entirely sure as to where that falls or if it's going to be safe to actually include it in there, but I cannot play this game without the fucking music, dude. There's no fucking way, okay? So that's where we stand with that. We'll see how it goes, but at the very least, I'll be making an update on the main channel to let you guys know, you know, when episodes come out and everything like that. I will have the playlist on the main channel as well and everything like that, so you don't have to worry. But subscribe to this channel if you are interested in the rewrite playthrough, and there will be more content on this channel as well. Any side projects that I really feel like doing, I'll probably bring over here. So definitely subscribe to this channel if you want to see some more diverse stuff aside from the content we normally have. With that said, getting into rewrite itself, man, I'm excited. And to kind of break the wall a little bit, this is after the anime has already begun, and I've been waiting to do this forever. I waited this long simply because, knowing they were doing the anime original route, I think it's perfect to have this playthrough alongside it, go down the common route, and potentially, you already know I'm going for that Kotori route first, man, and hopefully that is a route that you can access from the jump. This is going to be a blind playthrough, by the way. I'm not going to be using any guides or anything like that, so I do want to clarify that. But I do want to get to this Kotori route, so I'm going to do whatever it takes. You know, of course, I'm no stranger to visual novels, man. I'm going to have my separate save files and be moving towards that route to start off with. I would do the Akane route, but I know that there's some routes that you can't do without completing others first, and I'm not sure if that's one of them. So I'm either going to be going for Kotori or Akane straight out the gate, because I know those two are going to be my best girls, initially, based on what I've seen so far, man. Especially Kotori and Akane, man, it's too real. So we're going for that. As far as the voices, and let me get into these settings so I can make sure everything is on point. I did mess with this earlier. I kind of want the autosave off. Yeah, let me turn the autosave off, actually. And then I feel as though everything else where I want it. Yeah, I think we're good to go. With that said, you already know there's no way I am voice acting any of these goddesses. I need to hear the actresses themselves. I want to immerse myself fully in this project, but I will be doing Kotaro. I will be doing Kotaro. I'm going to try my best to imbue myself onto him, but at the same time keep his persona intact. I mean, there's like a splash of scumbagginess, you know, massive trolling vibes, and like I've been saying, as far as rewrite goes, Tennoji Kotaro has the potential to be one of my favorite, you know, visual novel protagonists of all time, rivaling the great, you know, Ho-Oh-In-Koma-Man hooding greatness. So, with all that said, please smash that button if you're excited for this playthrough, and we're gonna begin our journey right here. Let's go for that Kotori route, man. Let's go for that fucking Kotori route. It's time. Just the effects, man. Key just always goes in. Every time. Listen to that.
ある時, 何も持っていないことについて。The
purity in it. We got this nice aurora and the full moonlit nights. Such a relaxing vibe straight out the gate, man. I'm really going to enjoy this to the point where it may captivate my life for a good period if I really immerse myself. Probably end up bulk recording a shit ton. And of course, if Kotaro's actually has portions that are voice acted, I'm not going to speak over that. I want to hear it.
何を詰める努力もしてこなかったんだから。
当然だ。でも俺はそんなことさえわからなかった。漫然とした中身のない人生を歩いてきたからだ。そして、ある日突然、自分がたくさんの時間を失っていると感じた。俺は誰とでも話せた。どんな奴とでも。 Let's go, man!
親友はいなかった。ただの一人も。それがどういう事だか考えるまでもない。俺の人生は、ひどく薄っぺらいものだった。昔馴染みの神戸と言いかけが唯一気兼ねなく話せる友達だった。I don't like the use of that past tense right there.
I'll do it all over.
次はうまくやる。切なる願い。And
this is where I finally come to the heart of the matter too.
とても難しいことだ。It's
gonna be a temporal element to this.
みんな、It's
gonna make it even crazier than what I've already seen.
人は、自動的に幸せにはならない。People
don't find happiness automatically.
自力で幸せに歩いていかなければならないんだ。幸せって何だろう。 青春みたいなことだろうか? なら、 青春って…
This shit is gonna be deep.
なんか、 眩しいもの… と、 小鳥は言った。 知るか? いちいち考えることじゃねえ。 と、 吉野は吐き捨てた。 ずっと昔、 誰だかが人生のつながったり、と口にした。
Having dialogues with Yoshino, I know that already.
三人の意見は、 どれも正しいように思えた。眩しくて、知らなくて、恐ろしげなもの。難しいはずだ。それは、答えがないってことだから。でも、そんな物を探す旅を始めようと、俺は決めた。
Dude, this intro is heavy already. This is only the tip of the iceberg, a glimpse of what's to come.
I hadn't even glimpsed what I should be doing.
I need to steal my resolve right now because this shit's about to be crazy. It's gonna be a long, arduous, intense, and rewarding journey. I'm gonna enjoy this opening, although I'm probably gonna have to cut this out. I've heard this song a good amount of times at this point, but I haven't seen it in years. Right into a confrontation with the mad dog. Alright, listen. Thus spoke Yoshino Haruhiko, the only delinquent in our class.
Tennoji!
It's time to do. Sorry, Yoshino. I have no idea how to play cards.
Oh my god.
His eyes are serious. He's a lone wolf, as one might expect. But normally he's calm and collected. So there are surprisingly few people who know that he talks like a cheesy anime or manga character. He sees me as a rival for some reason. I've managed to avoid any conflict so far, but now that's all about to change. I greet him sociably during every break period. I follow him to the bath and watch him from behind. An absolute creep. I laugh out loud at every single cheesy line he says to show how well we get along. But really I do it to troll the shit out of him. I never stop displaying our friendship through kicking him in the back of his knees and such. Honestly, I can't even imagine why Yoshino's acting so gloomy. This is so sad, Yoshino. Friends as close as us should never fight. You sound serious. Alright, I accept. Endo. Okay, one thing though. Yoshino's seething rage makes me feel nihilistic. I won't go down that easily. Of course, I'll be there. Yeah, I know. A manly, passionate promise with the mad dog Yoshino. The mad dog. Kyoken. I completely forgot that promise and went straight home after school. I'm not a respectable person. I thoroughly enjoyed my late night television, never once remembering our promise. I had fun downtown on Saturday, never once remembering our promise. I even realized I'd broken our promise until late at night. It was far too late to regret it. I told myself I'd apologize to Yoshino the next chance I got. Then I went to sleep. Maybe the fact that I treat people lightly is what makes Yoshino dislike me so much. Oh well, I don't give a fuck. As punishment for that half-hearted lifestyle, a certain someone summoned me on Sunday night. Kotori hasn't come home yet. So, can you bring her back, please? They don't give Rikako any voice acting. Son, ready. Those two lines don't connect at all. I guess if there's somebody that's not voice acted, I'll go in with that also. Alright. I dare not obey her.
She's Madame Rikako, the mother of Kanbei Kotori, my childhood friend. We've been neighbors for a long time, and both of my parents get along with her, so to me, she has more authority than most relatives. Actually, this isn't the first time she's asked me to find her lost daughter. She wanders off all the time, and I know exactly where to look for her. I gathered up my equipment and off immediately. What equipment? What equipment do you have, my boy? Okay. I fiddle with my antique cell phone and start up an application. Ooh. This is an antique? You got GPS on this shit? A map appears on my phone. This thing's kind of like people version of a sat-nav. It came bundled with the phone. It records all terrain I walk through. It counts the number of steps I've taken and can give simple directions. I guess it's designed for people who like to take walks. It's fun to wander around buildings, has no data for it, and watch it automatically drop. Plus, I can always find my way out of the forest with this thing. It's pretty good. Now, move the map by clicking and dragging. Yo! I actually get to maneuver with this thing. That's peace, son, that's beast. Let's take a midnight stroll, shall we? A huge forest. I'm still close to town, so I can't see many animals or insects. They're probably hiding farther in, away from humans. The forest is a good place for kids to lay. That sounds cool as fuck, man, I'm sorry. Come to think of it, when I was little, I tried to catch staggle beetles here. I never found a single one. And that's why I'll never know the true form of a stag beetle. Not that I give a shit. And we're wandering. I came here a lot when I was little. But at some point I stopped playing here. Because I noticed something. There were no animals or insects in the forest. It felt like an empty world. And I found that boring. But Kotori still comes here a lot for some reason. No one goes with her. She has no friends. She's always alone. She never hangs out downtown. She never stays late partying. She spends all her free time in the forest. Feels a little lonely. That's why we should be accompanying her, my boy. Wait, is there anything this way? No. Dude, I like that we can navigate like this, man. This is quite unique. I think I've been walking for about 30 minutes. After coming this far, there's no longer any sign of the town. The forest is dark even during daytime. I feel uneasy, like I'm in a deep sleep. I've been here a lot, but it still unnerves me. Even when I was little, I never went this far in. I checked my... It's still charting my progress. No need to worry about getting lost. I pull out my flashlight and point it ahead of me. Thankfully, the moon is bright tonight. It looks so sexy. It's not that hard to walk around here. It's very quiet. It's so humid it feels like a tropical forest. But I can't hear a single insect. It's so unnatural, it makes me wonder if some supernatural creatures are hiding here. I have a baseball hat, bat, and a helmet, just in case, but I still don't feel safe. You brought the helmet too, son? Something about this beautiful forest is wrong. I wanna go home. Yo, stop being a little big. Right, let's go, let's man the fuck up and find this girl. Hey! Hey, Kotori! No answer. Maybe she's farther in. She's a dangerous life. Hey, are you there? Kotori-san! Ah! The fuck is this Neko? Oh, just a cat. Don't scare me like that. Shoo, shoo. He tries to intimidate me before running off. That was definitely someone's pet. Jeez. I continue walking as my heart pounds. I'm telling you, Kotori, we can't be this bitch made out here. Kya! There's out here? No insects, but you got these creatures lurking. Or it's just an old unglet. This man. It was a bore. For some reason, my embarrassment made me talk like an academic. Don't scare me like that. Go home now. The rest of the Zodiac is waiting for you. The boar snorted before leaving. That was a pretty rare find. Now I look like an idiot for saying there were no animals here. They're straight. Let's get in this thicket. It's this special kind of book that's always hearts of flame. I know no one's here, but I feel I need to check anyway.
Yes! I got it!
It's a pamphlet. God damn it! From the bottom of my heart,
God motherfucking damn it!
Where to now, son? What is this? Straying off the path.
Hey, Kotori! Time to go home. Kotori! Can you hear me?
Going even farther in might be tough.
Yeah!
Something's there. It's huge! The f- Oh, it's just- what? Just a- What the fuck is that? It's neither a cat nor a boar. It's neither a dog nor a fox. I don't think I've ever seen it before, but it feels familiar. Have we met somewhere?
Where was it?
The size of a large dog. It's round with a powerful body. Long hair. Long trunk. Long tusks. I know, this is a... That's right, it's just a mammoth. I saw it in a social studies textbook once. Apparently people used to hunt these things. Yo, can we adopt this thing? I've never seen one of you before. Stares at Miho for a while, but even eventually loses interest and looks away. It walks away calmly. Judging by its size, it's probably just a baby. When it's up, it'll be the size of a small hill. I'd better hurry, yo.
Telling me we can't go back for it, please.
I'm talking fast, and there's our destination. What's over here in this thicket, though? This is a tur-
Yo, we fuck.
That's what I get for being curious. Have I really wandered this deep into the forest? I can access it again. Am I gonna step on shit again? Oh, we're just analyzing it now.
Yeah, I can't stand this.
At least that's how I'd like to respond, but... Well then... See, something about it, it keeps me curious, but you know, I'm gonna head over here. We're gonna reach our destination. I stand still. It's that kind of fool me once, fool me twice thing. I keep stepping on turds three times.
Ah!
Goddess. Absolute goddess.
Son.
Wait, hold a second, hold on. Let me look at this so I can get myself a picture of this, because this is beautiful. It's absolutely adorable. You're sleeping? She's so defenseless. Now's the perfect to fondle those opi. I suddenly feel tired. All that worrying was for nothing. Kotori's been playing out here since she was a little kid. She showed no interest in stuff normal girls did, and chose instead to spend all her time in the forest. What's so fun about it? To be honest, her playing in the forest at night worries me. But Kotori knows this part of the forest better than anyone, and it's my job to look after her. I should be able to protect her if anything happens. Now let's bring her home. I poke her shoulder. Kotori doesn't mind being touched just a little.
Oh, so we can go for a little bit more then, my son.
Hey, wake up!
Wake up, bit, wake up!
You'll be able to sleep tonight if you sleep now.
Come on.
Damn it.
Hey, Kotori, wake up already.
I try shaking her harder. No good. Ah, well. I try shaking her again, but she's still not waking up. Her body feels cold too. She must have been sleeping for a while. There are two things in the situation. One, lure her with something she likes. Two, pressure her with something she hates. As much as I love to torture her, now we gotta go in from the jump and get this save data. I gotta delete this file too. You already know I'm gonna give her something just because I think that's the right move. As much as it would, as nice it would be to tease her a little bit, I need to get this route, man. And I realistically know that's the choice from the first episode of the end.
Kotori, I know you love this.
I take out of my pocket and drop it piece by piece into her palm. Pocket change. Kotori's brow furrows.
How's that?
That smile. Fucking adorable. Need that too. You're gonna see me do that shit a lot, man. I'm a fiend when it comes to screen caps in the visual novel. She stands up.
Okay, follow me, follow me.
Dude, I think by episode 2 I'm gonna have Kara's voice down, because I'm not really liking the one that I've started with. But slowly but surely I'm getting a picture of what I need to do with it. Kotori staggers behind me.
Good, good. Keep it up.
She's still half asleep.
You're like a zombie.
Just take the change, bitch. Oh my god, she sounds so adorable. It's a little scary. This music is too sexy, man. But we got back in one piece.
Wake up already! Just carried you all the way back, lead with coins.
I gently thump her back. Adorable. Looks around, then at me. Ohayo!
She looks around again, and her eyes widen.
No, Shirley. You're sleeping in the forest. You could say that. It's fine. You're sleeping really well, though. It was hard to wake you up. What? Like... Sure.
So, can it hold 500 coins? 20,000? Can she actually say that? Even if she put it in one day? Well, if she's happy, I guess it doesn't matter. Anyway, your mom was worried. Can't upset the mistress. You better go talk to her. She'll probably be mad, but you can handle it. If you need to run away, you can stay at my place. You've got a spare room. You can just sleep with me.
Oh,
trust me, I know.
You sure?
I think even they'd be mad about staying out this late. She's come home after sleep before, but this is a record for her.
Kotori-san, is that you? Wah!
Madame materialized without warning.
Don't just say it so quickly. She gives her daughter a single cold glance.
She wasn't hurt.
I'm glad you know it so well. I just stepped in shit.
If you say so.
That's it? She get quitted that easily? Madame Rikuko looks really harsh. But is she that lenient on her daughter? Her eyes fall on me.
Good work.
I lower my head like a servant. Can you pat it, please? Sorry it took a bit longer than expected.
No, you did well.
Thank you.
Okaa-san,
alright. Kotara-san, I'll read this in the near future. Reward? I gratefully accept. Good. Come by, Kotori-san. She gives off an air of urgency as she gracefully walks inside. Kotori stares at me. So, are you coming to school? Okay, shine. She stiffly waves her hand before following her mother. Okay, that's dealt with. Time to go back off. I feel someone watching me from behind. Fuck. It's gotta be a cat or a dog or something, or a malicious creeper ready to stab me. I should just get home. But as I start walking, something pushes forward from behind, engulfing my back. Like a sheet of silk. A thick sheet. I turn around. Nothing's there. No one's there. There's only the fist. But I can still feel the strange sensation wrapped around my neck. It's smooth but disturbing. A deep forest. A few seconds later, I get goosebumps.
almost running. Kotori said the forest was like her back, but I just couldn't agree with her on that. Late at night, I was starting to fall asleep when... Ah! Suddenly, somewhere grabbed my wrist. Their hands were cold as ice. Who's there? The fuck are you? I roll out of bed and turn on the lights. No one's there. Am I imagining things? I still feel it on my arm. I didn't try to pull by the arm, and their grip was strong enough to make me instantly wake up. As if it were about to pull my arm out of its socket. Fuck just happened. I look at my wrist under the light. I can see a clear mark where it was grabbed. A hand-shaped mark. I immediately faint. Cause I'm a little bitch sometimes. This has to be a dream, right? Nice. Day one complete. God's code illustration. This is gonna get the separate file going from the jump. Just in case I make any errors, say over this too, because I know that one was good. And I don't feel like stopping here, surprisingly, even though I probably should. I think we've done enough for the first time. My wrist. A chill runs down my spine. I check, but there's nothing there. Did I imagine all that? I should just forget that stuff. Focus on reality. Today... Kotori said she'd go to school today. This is an important day. I get back at dawn, so I've only been asleep for a few hours. I'm pretty tired, but I eat breakfast and get ready for school. I make my morning call. Is that you, Kotori? It's almost time for school. That's all I need to hear to understand her predicament. Kotori, did you... hey. Oh my god, she's too much love. Come on. Thought so. Could you get your stuff together and meet me outside? I'll wait 5 minutes. That's fine. Should've just called when I got up. I was hoping to go to school here once, but... We won't make it if we don't leave in 5 minutes. Should I wait anyway? I don't really care if I'm late. I really do want to wait for you. Okay then, I guess I'll go myself. Just to be sure, you're feeling okay, right? Probably because of that long nap yesterday. Anyway, see you later. I hang up and sigh. This is the combat I know. Dealing with her is pretty tough. I'll be at school alone today as usual. Let's go. Interesting. So we gotta follow this path to school. Alright. I think this is where I'm episode one. I gotta refine my Kotaro voice a little bit. Get it ready to go. Once this is up, I don't want to make this too long also just in case anything goes wrong with it. So once this is up, we'll have a good idea of how everything's, the quality-wise. I want to get you guys' feedback, in terms of anything to take, audio, you know, if everything's good visually, and yeah, I don't know if I want to read every bit of dialogue to get drag. I'm also going to increase the text speed to instant, because I don't need it to kind of trickle like that. I thought fast would be fast enough, but it's not. But... I'm ready, man. This is a lot of fun. I can already feel it. So, let me know your thoughts on this first episode, and I'll catch you guys in episode 2, which will definitely be longer. And hopefully everything goes well with this first episode. Smash that like button if you enjoy, you're ready for more rewrite content, and I'm out. Peace.